Well, I guess it was what I wanted to do is I wanted to present the story in sort of the stylized way overall, the way that Mr. Dickens wrote it. I think that he not you know his when you listen you read his descriptions in the story, not only are the environments and the way he describes the rooms and London and the fog and the temperature, but also the characters, they're all a bit stylized. So they look a little more hyper-real than reality, which is, of course, the only way we could do movies until we had these digital tools. Well, it probably was the first classic story I ever read as a child, and I think probably the first Dickens story. And I guess it stuck with me forever. But sure. I loved it as a child. Yeah. Sure. Right. Well, what happens in performance capture is you literally get to separate out performance from production. So you work only with the actor. And you work with the actor as if you're doing theater, and you don't have to worry about lights or cameras or marks or any of that sort of thing. So you really can work on the performance. You can do it without breaking it up for coverage or camera angles. And you know, once you get your performance the way you want it, then you know you can just easily put in your and comfortably put in your cameras, and you don't have to beat your actors up and make them twist them into pretzels to do specific shots that you're thinking of. I mean, you have to be a very good actor to work in this form, because you have to be able to imagine what you're wearing. You have to be able you can't hide behind your wardrobe. You can't hide behind your wig or anything like that. So your acting is very pure. But you know, if you're a really good actor, you have no problem at all. I haven't spoken to them. In having a long personal conversation. But, when I do, I'm going to have to talk to them about how much they want to do as far as performing in the piece, you know. Yeah, I mean, you know, we have the tools now where we can actually really make a spectacular version of Roger Rabbit if the screenplay turns out to be something that's really good, and that's what it always depends on. It depends on, it probably should be made in the tradition of the first movie.